You often see us reporting on scams that target the elderly, but a new study suggests their own family members are the ones most likely to take advantage. Valley News Team's Rose Itzkovitz explains how, when it comes to financial abuse toward elders, it's often all in the family.
The expression, "the apple doesn't fall far from the tree," is usually a good thing.
They know that they're not going to get any money from me.
But not when the apple is snatched from the branch.
Go out and get a job.
A new study from the University of California says that may be the case more often than you think. Of more than 800 calls to the National Center on Elder Abuse, more than half cited financial abuse.
Does it sound realistic to you?
Yes.
At 48%, the perps most commonly ID'd, the elders' own flesh and blood.
It's just devastatingly sad. We've seen that more than once.
Brian Arrett has worked with seniors for 40 years. He says financial abuse often starts out innocently.
A son or a daughter or another relative might be helping mom or dad, you know, with their checkbook, for instance, helping pay bills. All of a sudden, out of the blue, they might write a check to themselves.
It's usually things like stealing checks from checkbooks. It's usually like using their credit cards, making withdrawals from the accounts.
Experts say to look for red flags, like out-of-pattern purchases.
Maybe a lot of online purchases, for instance, if the person is not so computer savvy, for instance.
And the best thing to do is file a police report and check in with the bank.
Most banks do have structures in place to prevent things like that.
But we're told sometimes the hardest obstacle to overcome is embarrassment.
I guess the problem becomes whether the elder is actually willing to admit that.
They've always wanted, you know, to help their child succeed. And the embarrassment is because they've got a child that is doing something that's obviously wrong.
Letting them realize that this is really not something to be ashamed of.
So if it's your loved one getting ripped off, even if by another loved one, the best thing you can do is encourage action. In Fargo, Rose Iskovitz, Valley News Live.
In the study, though, the abuse most reported among elders was financial. The second most common was emotional abuse at 35% and neglect at 20%. For more resources, you can head to our website and click on this story.